Throughout military history, cities have always been important targets. It's a source of supply, labor, production, riches, and in many cases, resistance. As a result, all the way back to the earliest times in military history, we have examples of siege warfare. Cutting off a target and using the surrounding military force to wear the city down before it either crumbles as resistance fails or surrenders to avoid starvation. However, which cities have been besieged the most in history? I decided to find out. First, I wanted to set some guidelines on what I mean by a besieged city. To count, it has to involve a military force directly surrounding the city or cutting its supplies off in the area with the goal of being able to get past the defenses and take the city, whether temporarily in a sacking or for an outright conquest. Sometimes cities would have battles over them, but that doesn't mean it's a siege. Since this list is about cities, that also means it doesn't include sieges of isolated castles and forts. I don't have time to look through every single infrastructure that's been besieged in all of history, but cities I think is reasonable. Perhaps the most interesting thing about this question is all of the top contending cities are from Europe and the Middle East. It's not surprising to me that they would have a lot of cities up on this list. I just kind of expected at least one city from India or East Asia to compete. If I had to make a theory, India and Japan mostly had their sieges involve castles and forts, and so at most a city of theirs might have been besieged three times at most, but it wasn't enough to rank high on this list. As for China, aside from long periods of being unified compared to Europe, which skews the numbers, the important cities kept changing. As a result, a place rarely got besieged more than twice in China. The other continents also didn't really compete either. Europeans in the Middle East simply loved their sieges. But before we get to the most besieged cities in history, I'm going to talk about this video sponsor, Ridge Wallets. I remember a horrible time a few years ago when I had a normal leather wallet and I'd take a walk in the rain for like a mile. And I didn't mind walking in the rain, but at one point a car drove by and splashed a puddle of water all over the side of my jeans. And that happened to be the side of the jeans with my wallet, and that was actually enough to ruin it. I mean, it wasn't a super expensive wallet, but at the same time, it was really disappointing to have a wallet that was so fragile like that. And it's why I still use Ridge Wallets, because the metal wallets, aside from being simple and compact, are immune to water damage. If you use the link in the description with the code Emperor, you can get your own Ridge Wallet with a 10% off deal. So get your Ridge Wallet today. It's well worth it. So let's take a look at the top 10 most besieged cities in history. Number 10 is Belgrade in Serbia, with 10 sieges. Belgrade was interesting because I've seen some varying claims to say the least, but 10 seemed to be the most accurate number. Keep in mind the area Belgrade is on has been continually inhabited for thousands of years, but that doesn't mean it's specifically Belgrade. Number 9, also with 10 sieges, is the Italian city of Pavia. Pavia is ranked higher because it hit 10 sieges first. And it makes sense that an Italian city would be here, as Italy has been historically divided for a long time, which means not only have there been tons of Italian states fighting each other, but also bigger nations fighting their way through Italy. I was just kind of surprised that Pavia was apparently this high of a target. And there were also notable sieges between the Lombards and the Byzantines over Pavia as well. Number 8 is the former Islamic cultural capital of the world, Baghdad. With Baghdad being in one of the most contested regions on the planet of Mesopotamia, it's no surprise that it's a primary target, and then its medieval prestige culturally and economically increased its value. As a result, from medieval times all the way up to World War I, it has dealt with 11 sieges. Meanwhile, number 7, we have the ancient city of Tyre in modern-day Lebanon, a city that has been around for almost 5,000 years but has been besieged 11 times, including famously by Alexander the Great, where he used stones from nearby ruins to build a bridge to the island Tyre was on, which has since remained on a peninsula. Like before, Tyre ranks higher because it got to 11 sieges first. For number 6, we have the mighty city of Rome with 12 sieges. What I found kind of fascinating was that 3 of these sieges happened 3 years in a row for Rome. People like to talk about the Visigoths sacking Rome as if it was like a hit-and-run type thing on their way to Spain, but in reality, the Visigoths besieged Rome in 408 before retreating for the winter, then again in 409 before retreating, and then a third time in 410, in which that time they finally succeeded and sacked the city. A more modern one was in 1849 when rebels had overthrown the papal government in Rome, and French forces under Napoleon III had to besiege Rome for a month before they were able to put the Pope back on the throne. For number 5, we have the one Italian city with even more sieges than Rome or Pavia, and it's not even on the main peninsula. It's the ancient city of Syracuse on the island of Sicily. Its importance in Greco-Roman history cannot be understated. I mean, it's part of the reason why, like, the Punic Wars happened. It was a natural stopping point in ancient Mediterranean trade and travel, making it a lucrative target, which caused it to endure 13 sieges. But it's not the most important area in the Mediterranean that's been besieged. Number 4 is Gibraltar. While Gibraltar is a rock and a territory of the United Kingdom, it is also technically a city. Its strategic importance as the western gateway in and out of the Mediterranean has made it significantly important for centuries, for militaries, as well as, of course, privateers. It's really no wonder that Gibraltar has been besieged 14 times in history, and they're even called sieges 1 through 14, which is kind of funny. Number 3 is Aleppo, the oldest city on this list. Yet despite that, it actually has the most recent example of a siege on this list, having been besieged during the currently ongoing Syrian civil war between 2012 and 2016. Thanks to ancient warfare, crusaders, and modern rebels, this city has been besieged 16 times, which is impressive, even though it's spaced out over 6 millennia. Number 2 is the Holy City of Jerusalem. I mean, really, is it that surprising that the most contested holy city of all time wouldn't be somewhere on this list? Although, admittedly, I personally was surprised that it was this high up. I figured there'd be like 12 to 15 sieges, which is a lot, but it would be more in the middle of this list. However, even if we were to call into question some biblical history in terms of legitimacy, we're pretty sure that Jerusalem has endured at least 21 sieges. Even if questionable historicity knocks one or two off the tally, it'd still be more than Aleppo. So it's a solid second place. However, now that you know numbers 2 through 10, I imagine half of you watching now immediately know number 1. So the most besieged city in all of history was something I didn't find surprising at all. It was my guess going into this research, and while Jerusalem made an impressive tally, it didn't quite reach this one. Istanbul, formerly known as Constantinople, is the most besieged city in all of human history. So many people tried to penetrate its famous walls, and very few succeeded. It's where Europe met Asia, where the Black Sea met the Mediterranean. It's been attacked by Persians, Arabs, Russians, Bulgarians, Crusaders, Turks. Frankly, I'm surprised China didn't sneak one in there at some point. Not to mention, some sieges occurred due to Byzantine civil wars. The total for Istanbul/Constantinople starts at 26 sieges. Wait a minute, what's with the language starts at 26? Well, it's because of another important part of the city's history. Constantinople was its former name, but even before that, it was called Byzantium. Unlike, say, Babylon and Baghdad, this wasn't a new city built nearby older ruins. These were just simply name changes. So for all intents and purposes, it's the same city, which means if I include the sieges of Byzantium, it adds another 10, making a grand total of 36 sieges. And since 1453 was the final siege, that means none of them were in the past 500 years. Even Baghdad and Aleppo had sieges past 1900, but not Istanbul. The meme city is a meme city for a reason. Hope you all enjoyed the video. Be sure to like and subscribe, but also comment on what cities you were surprised to see on this list or surprised not to see. Personally, I kind of thought Paris would have been somewhere in there, but, you know, guess not. Either way, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.